religious blasphemous territory that I am venturing into, because it is not up to me to disagree with my brother, the GOAT, the greatest of all time, Michael Jordan. But I'm going to challenge Michael Jordan on that. I'm going to say that he is wrong, and I completely and emphatically disagree with him. First of all, I don't even need to debate this subject with Max Kellerman, because Max Kellerman had absolutely no validity, no justification for disagreeing with me about LeBron James being a better two-way player because of what Max Kellerman has been bloviating about all year long. He makes the right plays, he does the right things, he makes everybody better, blah, blah, blah. He can do what he wants, when he wants. When he's on the court, they win. When he's off the court, they lose. This is all the stuff that he said about LeBron James. So based on Max Kellerman's own words, he has no credibility to disagree with me about LeBron James being a better three-way, a better two-way player. Remember, Kawhi Leonard just averaged over 20 points.
So
I meant to. But remember, Kawhi Leonard just started averaging over 20 points a game the season before last, 2 years ago. That's number one. Number two, even though he can score and he is exceptional defensively and all of that, there's a lot to his game that he may not bring in terms of passing and other things and making guys around him better. Not to say that he doesn't, just not to LeBron James level. He's not the complete basketball player that LeBron James is. That's one. Guess what? Dude in New Orleans named Anthony Davis, two on my list for best two-way player. That goes to you too, Mr. Michael Jordan. You know why? Because there's this dude in New Orleans named Anthony Davis who just finished averaging 28 on 11.8 rebounds, on 50% shooting from the field, on 2.2 block shots per game, who, by the way, has been averaging over 20 points per game since his second year in the league. He's constantly a vocal point. He didn't have Manu and Tim Duncan and Parker with Greg Popovich coaching to cover him. It's been about Anthony Davis. Just like for the most part, it's been about LeBron James. Kawhi Leonard is a superstar. He's big time. Mad respect to him. But the best two-way play in the game, I just gave you two dudes that I would have to take before him. LeBron's older, so obviously, you know, if you want to take Kawhi because he's younger, that's different. But I'm just talking about right now. Best two-way player, LeBron James, Anthony Davis.
Well, you said a lot of good things there, actually, and you tried to head me off at the pass by bringing up what I've said in the past about LeBron, and you're right.
If
the question is basketball in the modern NBA, the answer is LeBron. Who's the best player? LeBron. Who's the most valuable player? However you want to define it, LeBron. That's the most valuable synonym, by the way. I hate to break it to people. Who's the best two-way player? LeBron. Postseason player. LeBron. All that's true, and yet Michael Jordan's not wrong, because the spirit of what he's saying is this, Stephen A. Bill James once wrote about this, the godfather of baseball sabermetrics. When people were asking, like, who's the best brother tandem to ever play in Major League Baseball? Oh, Hank Aaron and his brother, this guy and that brother. And Bill James's point was, the real answer is if Babe Ruth had a brother, him and his brother would be the best baseball players ever. In other words, what we're asking when we say two-way player, we're not saying take the overall value of that player and divide it by two, and that's the best two-way player. We're not saying that. We're just taking the best player who also has to play defense. What we're really asking here, what we're really saying is, who is the best player where their value, their offensive and defensive value, are most closely aligned? When it's closest to 50-50, their value as a player, offense, defense. And in that respect,